Welcome back everyone. Today's video is continuation of the previous video of mathematical methods. If you haven't seen that video, please go and see that video. It consists of the previous questions which we have already done from the chapter. Here we are going to continue the remaining questions. So now let's start. The question is, show that vectors a bar equals to 2i cap plus 5j cap minus 6k cap and b bar is equal to I cap plus 5 by 2 j cap minus 3k cap are parallel to each other. The first thing that you have to write here is given. Given is the two vectors a bar and b bar which we have already written, and next thing we have to write what we have to find out or what we have to show. So we here have to show that a bar and b bar are parallel to each other. Now let's go to the solution. So the solution is, in order to show the two vectors are parallel to each other, the angle between the two vectors should be equal to 0 degrees. So here I am drawing these two vectors. What does this mean? It means that we have a vector, okay, and we have a vector which is a bar, and we have another vector which is b bar. The angle between these two vectors is 0 degrees. Why 0 degrees? It means that if I draw this vector a bar over this b bar, then the angle which is made by these two vector is 0 degrees. Now suppose they have told us the angle made is 90 degrees, then what we should assume or we should visualize is one vector which is perpendicular to the other vector. So if this is a bar, then this was going to be b bar. Okay, so this is not given in your this question has not been asked in your question. Only 0 degrees has been asked, so we will stick to 0 degrees. So the angle between the two vectors is 0 degrees if they are parallel to each other. Now let the angle between the two vectors be equal to theta. So cos theta is given by a bar dot b bar upon magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar. So magnitude of a bar, magnitude of b bar. Magnitude of a bar will be given by square root of ax square plus ay square plus az square if there are three axes x, y and z. If there are just two axes, then it will be square root of ax square plus ay square, okay. And magnitude of b bar will be given as square root of bx square plus by square plus bz square. Okay, so now next we have to substitute the values of a bar, b bar and its magnitudes. So on substituting the values, this particular vector, this is vector a bar, this is vector b bar, which is already given to you. So magnitude of this particular a bar is ax is 2, ay is 5 and az is minus 6. Okay, this minus 6 will come with its sign. Similarly, for the second vector b bar, it is going to be bx is going to be 1, by is going to be 5 by 2 and bz is going to be minus 3. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to take dot product, and in the previous video I have already taught this where I have explained you I dot I, j dot j and k dot k, these all are equal. Why these all are equal? It will give you answer to be 1. Since these all are unit vectors, hence I am getting answer to be equal to 1. If there is another combination such as I cap dot j cap, okay, and j cap dot k cap or k cap dot I cap, then in such cases this is not going to be equal, okay, it will give me answer as 0. Why it is so? Because p bar dot q bar is equal to pq cos theta, and if theta is equal to 90 degrees, then cos of 90 degrees equals to 0. Hence p bar dot q bar is equal to 0. So whatever combinations आर ऑफ आई जे जे के आई के और एनी अदर प्रोडक्ट विल गिव मी आंसर एज जीरो. सो ओनली मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस टू वैक्टर्स विल नॉट गिव मी आंसर एज जीरो आर आई कैप इंटू आई कैप, जे कैप इंटू जे कैप एंड के कैप इंटू के कैप. सो हैंस इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप वॉट आई हैव डन ईयर इज आई हैव मल्टीप्लाइड दिस टू आई विथ दिस आई कैप ऑफ द सेकेंड वैक्टर प्लस फाइव जे कैप विथ प्लस 5/2 जे कैप एंड माइनस 6 k कैप विथ माइनस 3 k कैप. ओके सो यू कैन सी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट. सो दिस इज आई कैप डॉट आई कैप ब्रैकेट, दिस इज जे कैप डॉट जे कैप ब्रैकेट एंड दिस इज के कैप डॉट के कैप ब्रैकेट. ये डॉट प्रोडक्ट इज देयर. ओके एंड बिलो जस्ट एडिशन स्क्वेयरिंग एंड एडिशन. सो स्क्वेयर ऑफ 2 इज 4, स्क्वेयर ऑफ 5 स्क्वेयर इज 25 एंड माइनस 6 स्क्वेयर इज 36. ओके मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स गेट कन्फ्यूज हियर दैट हाउ कम माइनस 6 स्क्वेयर इज 36. ओके सो माइनस इंटू माइनस इज प्लस, जस्ट मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ साइन मेक्स द साइन टू बी पॉजिटिव. हियर ऑल्सो 1 स्क्वेयर इज 1, 5/2 स्क्वेयर इज 25/4 एंड माइनस 3 स्क्वेयर बिकम्स 9 विच इज ऑल्सो पॉजिटिव. ओके सो नाउ नेक्स्ट मूव ऑन टू कॉस थीटा. सो हियर इन द अबव स्टेप इफ यू लुक देन आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ आई इंटू आई विल गिव मी आंसर एज 1, जे इंटू जे ऑल्सो 1 एंड के कैप इंटू के कैप विल ऑल्सो गिव मी आंसर एज 1. सो डायरेक्टली आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई 2 इंटू 1 इज 2, आई गॉट ए आंसर 2. 5 इंटू 5/2 विल गिव मी 25/2, 5 5s are 25 एंड डिनोमिनेटर विल रिमेन सेम एंड माइनस 6 इंटू माइनस 3 विल गिव मी आंसर एज 6 3s are 18 एंड माइनस इंटू माइनस विल गिव मी आंसर एज प्लस. सो नो चेंज इन द आउटसाइड साइन. द डिनोमिनेटर विल बिकम स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 4 प्लस 25 प्लस 36 विच इज 65 एंड हियर इट विल बिकम 1 प्लस 25 बाय 4 प्लस 9. ओके सो वॉट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू डू मल्टीप्लाई दिस हियर विथ 1 एंड एड दिस 4 टू 25, सो 29 बाय 4 एंड नेक्स्ट इज 29 बाय 4 प्लस 9. ओके सो जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई अगेन विथ 9 एंड जस्ट एड 25, यू विल गेट आंसर एज 65 बाय 4. सो फर्दर मूविंग ऑन इन न्यूमरेटर साइड वी विल गेट 65/2 एंड इन द डिनोमिनेटर साइड वी विल गेट स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 65 ब्रैकेट ऑफ, जस्ट वी आर सेपरेटिंग द स्क्वायर रूट साइंस फॉर न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर. सो स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 65 अपॉन स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 4. सो कॉस थीटा विल बिकम 65/2 अपॉन 65/2. सो दिस 65 रूट ऑफ 65 इज मल्टीप्लाई विद रूट ऑफ 65. ओके सो रूट ऑफ 65 इंटू रूट ऑफ 65 विल गिव यू आंसर एज जस्ट 65. ठीक है बिकॉज 65 रूट कैन बी रिटन एज 1/2 इंटू, ओके 65 रेस टू 1/2. सो बेस वैल्यूज आर सेम देयरफॉर 1/2 प्लस 1/2. ओके सो 65 रेस टू 4/4, 4 1s are 4 1s are 65 बाय रेस टू 1 इज इक्वल टू 65. ओके सो हेंस द वैल्यू इन द न्यूमरेटर विल कम आउट टू बी 65 एंड इन द डिनोमिनेटर सिंस इट इज 4 इट इज परफेक्ट स्क्वायर ऑफ 2 सो वी कैन राइट इट एज 2. सो कॉस थीटा विल हैव वैल्यू 1. सो वी कैन राइट दिस कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 एज थीटा इज इक्वल टू कॉस इनवर्स ऑफ 1. सो एट वॉट पर्टिकुलर एंगल्स ऑफ कॉस डू वी गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस टू बी 1. सो कॉस वैल्यू इज 1 व्हेन थीटा इज 0 डिग्रीज और 360 डिग्रीज. ओके सो वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट योर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 0 डिग्रीज. सो एंगल बिटवीन द टू वेक्टर्स ए बार एंड बी बार इज 0 डिग्री, हेंस दे आर पैरेलल टू इच अदर. आई हैव ऑल्सो सेड दिस इन द लास्ट प्रीवियस वीडियो द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ राइटिंग फाइनल आंसर बिकॉज फाइनल आंसर विल गिव द एग्जामिनर थिंकिंग दैट यस यू नो वॉट यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट एंड यू हैव ऑलरेडी फाउंड आउट वॉट यू हैव टू. ओके सो फाइनल आंसर इज जस्ट इवेल्युएशन पार्ट ऑफ योर पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन, डोंट मिस इट, ऑलवेज राइट इट, इट माइट गिव यू मार्क्स एंड इट माइट क्रिएट अ गुड इम्प्रेशन ऑन द टीचर. So now let's move to the next question. So this is interesting question. Question number three first. Now we have moved from question number two to question number three. So in this question, we have to find out cross product of two vectors, A bar cross B bar. Given the two vectors, A bar is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap and B bar is equal to 3i cap plus 5j cap. The answer that they have given here is, you can see here, the answer that we have to find out is k cap. Our answer should be k cap. So let's do this. First write down given. Your given, your two find will create a good impression on the teacher. Okay, write down solution. Now next move on to the actual solving of the problem. Now how will we solve this problem, since we have to find out cross product of two vectors? The cross product of two vector general formula is given by A bar cross B bar is equal to determinant. So this is determinant sign. Okay, determinant of 3 by 3 determinant. So I cap, J cap, K cap. Okay, so cross product of two vectors I am taking, I cap, J cap and K cap. Next is, these are the magnitudes of vector A bar. So AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, BZ. Okay, so now next move on. Now you can see here that I have just replaced this AX, AZ and BZ by zeros, since it is magnitude. So next move on, A bar cross B bar is equal to determinant of I cap, J cap, K cap, 230, 350. Okay, so now cross multiply, we have to solve this determinant, not cross multiply, we have to solve this determinant. And how we can solve this determinant, then just look here. So whenever you are solving determinant, there are few steps that you should follow. The first step is, whenever you are finding out determinant, so first I will consider I cap, okay, and next I am going to give bracket, okay, opening bracket, and after opening bracket, whenever I am considering I cap, at that time I am going to neglect the column which is below I cap, okay, and the row which is side of I cap. So these all terms I am going to neglect in our answer for time being, okay, and whatever the remaining array of numbers is there. So here the remaining array of number is 3, 0, 5, 0. Okay, so this is the remaining array, and this remaining array I am going to perform cross multiplication. So 3 into 0 minus of 5 into 0. Okay, these are steps we are going to perform here. So let's do it. So 3 into 0 minus of 5 into 0. Now next we are going to consider J term. Okay, so in case of J term, I am going to write here minus of J. Always second J term will be represented by minus sign outside. Again opening bracket. Now neglect this 3 and 5 which are below J, and I cap and J cap in jth row. Okay, in this row you neglect I cap and J, K cap, and below J you neglect 3 and 5. Now remaining terms are 2, 3, 0, 0. Now multiply 2 by 0. So 2 into 0 minus of 3 into 0. Okay, so internal sign, separation sign will always be negative. Now plus I cap, minus J cap. Now again alternate plus and minus goes on. So K cap comes, and at that time I'm going to neglect zeros which are below K cap, and I and J which are there in the kth row. So now K cap will become 2 into 5 minus 3 into 3. Okay, so in this way you can solve any determinant. Now you will get the answer as 3 into, you will get answer as 3 into 0 is 0, 5 into 0 is 0, 2 into 0 is 0, and 3 into 0 is 0. Means this comes out to be 0, this comes out to be 0. So my complete I term will be 0, this also J term will also be 0. Okay, so my complete J term will be 0, and the final, only the non-zero value which I am going to get in our determinant is from K cap. So K cap into 2 into 5, 5 2s are 10, okay, and 3 minus 3 into 3 is 9. So k cap into 10 minus 9. So 10 minus 9 is 1. Okay, so 1 k cap I have written here, and a bar cross b bar is equal to k cap, which I have to prove. Always write the final answer. Don't forget to write down the final answer. So cross product of a bar and b bar is a bar cross b bar is equal to k cap. So this was the required answer that we have to prove. Now let's move on to the next sum. So this is question number 2 from main question number 3. The question is, show that vector a bar and b bar and c bar are mutually perpendicular. So they have given us vector a bar, b bar and c bar, which are in terms of I cap, j cap and k cap. So these are resolved into I cap, j cap and k cap. So to show that a bar, b bar and c bar are mutually perpendicular, so always write given, always write to show that or to find whatever is required. Okay, so in order to find out these three vectors are mutually perpendicular, mutually perpendicular means that your angle theta should be equal to 90 degrees. So if we consider Cartesian coordinate system, okay, of x, y and z axis, then we come to know that angle between x and y is 90 degree, the angle between z and y is 90 degree, and angle between y and angle between x and z is 90 degree. So such kind of angles are called as mutually perpendicular. Such type of vectors are called as mutually, not angles, but mutually perpendicular lines or vectors. So let's move on. So we have to prove that our three vectors a bar, b bar and c bar are mutually perpendicular vectors. Now how we can prove this? So we have a dot product where we can say that p bar dot q bar, this I have already written in the above one of the sum. So p bar dot q bar is product of magnitude of two vectors and cos of angle theta between the two vectors. Okay, so if theta is equal to 90 degrees, then cos of 90 degree will give me answer 0. So on substituting this 0 in above this particular star equation, then PQ into 0. So this will give me answer as 0. Therefore, if I multiply these two vectors and angle between these two vectors is 90 degree, the answer is always going to be 0. And hence I can say here that P bar and Q bar are perpendicular to each other. Okay, this was for understanding purpose. Using this understanding, I have to find out A bar dot B bar equals to 0, B bar dot C bar equals to 0. Hence if these two are perpendicular to each other, we can say that other all vectors, that is A bar, B bar and C bar, are mutually perpendicular to each other. So in short, we have to show that a bar dot b bar is equal to b bar dot c bar is equal to 0. That is a bar dot b bar equals to 0 and b bar dot c bar equals to 0. Now let's perform our first sum, that is a bar dot b bar equals to 0. So this is our first vector, dot product, and this is our second vector. It is not normal multiplication, but it is dot product of two vectors. A bar dot b bar is equal to multiplication of I terms. So this is going to multiply with this. This is going to multiply it with this, and this will be multiplied with this term. I cap dot I cap, j cap dot j cap and k cap dot k cap with their signs. Don't forget the signs. Signs are very much important. So a bar dot b bar will fetch me 2 I cap dot 3 j cap. So 2 threes are 6. I cap dot I cap will be the final answer there. So it will become 6. I cap dot I cap is 1. So 6 plus 6 threes are 18 and negative sign, so minus 18 plus 6 twos are 12. K cap dot K cap is going to be equal to 1. So A bar dot B bar is equal to 6 plus 12 is 18. So plus 18 minus 18 will give me answer as 0. So I got your first answer, A bar dot B bar is equal to 0. Hence, angle between A bar and B bar is 90 degrees. Now we will perform b bar dot c bar. This is the first vector, dot product with the c bar vector. Okay, again perform the same operation, multiply 3 I cap with 6 I cap, minus 6 j cap with plus 2 j cap, and plus 2 k cap with minus 3 k cap. Okay, so next term, I cap into I cap, I cap dot I cap will be 1. So 3, 6 3s are 18, minus 6 into 2, 6 2s are 12, hence minus 12, and minus 3 into 2, minus 6. Therefore, plus 18 minus 18 will give me answer as 0. This shows that angle between B bar and C bar vector is 90 degrees. Okay, I hope you got this answer. How we did it. So from 1 and 2, we can say that given vectors A bar and B, A bar, B bar and C bar are mutually perpendicular to each other. Okay. So now let's move to the next sum. The question is similar to what we have done in the previous case, but here the answer what they have asked is different. The condition here is different. So determine the vector product of two vectors. They have given us v1 bar and they have given us v2 bar. Okay, so previously we had find out scalar product, that is dot product, and here we are going to find out cross product, which is called as vector product. Okay, so in order to find out vector product, we should know how to solve the determinant. I hope you have understood how to solve the determinant, which I have done in the previous question, and we will again understand the same thing here. Okay, so let's proceed. So given is v1 bar is equal to 2 I cap plus 3 j cap minus k cap, and v2 bar is equal to I cap plus 2 j cap minus 3 k cap. So this is the question, this is the given to us. We have to find out cross product and understand there is difference between multiplication and cross. Okay, so in physics paper, anything which looks like multiplication is not a multiplication. Okay, so dot and cross are two different things. So you should use very carefully the dot and the cross. So here it is not multiplication. V1 bar is not multiplied with V2 bar. Okay, so here it is cross product. So whenever such thing is asked to you, usually they will not write a multiplication sign, which they have written here, but they will use words such as vector product. So they will be using such type of words where you should come to know that this I have to find out cross product. So v1 bar cross v2 bar is given by I cap, j cap, k cap, v1x, v1y and v1z. So v1x, v1y and v1z are components of v1 bar. Okay, so v2x, v2y and v2z are components of v2 bar. So just we are going to substitute the values of its magnitude. Okay, so with their signs, don't forget their signs are important. So now after substituting the values of v1 bar and v2 bar in the determinant, we are going to get I cap, j cap, k cap, 2 3 minus 1 1 2 3. So now how we will find out the determinant? Now consider the first I cap. So below I cap, I am going to neglect this part, okay, and I am going to neglect this row. So this column and this row is going to be neglected, and only thing that is going to remain is 3 minus 1, 2 minus 3. Now cross multiply 3 into minus 3 minus of 2 into minus 1. So this is the first part here. Okay. Now consider J. So j cap, just neglect these two terms below and this I cap and j cap. Now perform cross multiplication on 2 into minus 3 and minus 1 into minus 1. So these two will be separated by negative sign. Okay. Now consider this k cap. So whenever I am finding out k cap, at that time this 1 and minus 3 will be neglected and this I and j terms will be neglected. So whatever remaining terms are there, 2, 3, 1, 2 will be cross multiplied by keeping negative sign between them. So here you can see these are the terms, and its multiplication 3 into minus 3 is minus 9, minus of 2 into minus 1 will give me minus, into minus will give me plus, so plus 2, minus j cap 3 into 2 is 6, minus 6 plus, minus into minus will give me plus sign, so plus 1, and here 2 into 2 is 4, minus separation 3 into 1 is 3. So final answer comes out to be v1 bar cross v2 bar is equal to minus 7i cap plus 5j cap plus k cap. So this was the required answer. Always write the final answer. Okay, always write the final answer. This will be homework for you. Now let's move on to the next question. So this question is little bit different as compared to the previous questions which we have solved, where we have found out dot product, cross product, we have found out magnitude, we have found out angle theta between the two vectors, whether they are parallel or they are perpendicular to each other. So now in this question, they have given us two vectors, v1 bar and v2 bar. Okay, so in one of the vectors, you can see that there is something missing, that is A, they have written. Okay, there is no number at this place of A. So these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So angle between these two vectors is 90 degrees. So we have to determine the value of A in this equation, in this particular sum. Okay, so let's solve this question. So we have V1 bar and V2 bar are perpendicular to each other. Hence, angle theta is equal to 90 degrees. So we are going to consider dot product of these two vectors, which will give us V1, V2 cos of 90 degrees. So cos of 90 degrees is 0. Hence, the complete right hand side will take value to be 0. Okay, now let's move forward. So substitute value of V1 and V2 means whatever vectors which are given to us, we should substitute those particular vector values onto the left hand side of this equation. Okay, this equation star. And right hand side will always remain 0. Since we are trying to make an equation in which left hand side we will get single value A and right hand side we will shift all the numerical values. Okay, so variable will be on left hand side and other all numbers will be on right hand side. So this is the V1 vector, this is V2 vector with A here and 0. Just perform dot product operation, phi I cap dot A I cap and 2j cap dot minus 6j cap. Okay, so next is I cap into I cap is equal to 1, therefore phi into A is phi A plus minus 6 into 2 is minus 12 is equal to 0. So phi A minus 12 plus minus is minus. So now next is phi A minus 12 is equal to 0. So phi A equals to 12. Just take this minus 12 on right hand side. This negative sign will be converted into positive sign. So since it is in the numerator, we are just going to change the sign. The final answer means when it moves towards the right hand side, it will move into the numerator, not into the denominator. So don't make mistake here. Don't shift your number into the denominator. Okay? So phi A is equal to 12. Therefore, A is equal to 12 upon 5. Therefore, the required value of A is 12 upon 5. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video informative, please do like, share, and subscribe to Audaz Academy YouTube channel. Thank you.